Hello class 8, today we are going to continue with chapter 1 and the topic would be reformation. So before we start with reformation and the causes of reformation, it is important to know the background. By the 16th century, the Roman Catholic Church was very powerful and controlled what their followers could and could not do. So there was no freedom. Whatever the church is going to say, they are going to, common people is going to follow that. Additionally, the Roman Catholic Church controlled approximately 1/3 of the land in Europe and claimed authority over all the kings. So the king, you know, here also you can see reason. Rulers were tired of Pope because the Pope is now interfering in the political activity of the country. So the ruler is losing their power. So this was not liked by the king or the ruler or that respective country or nation. This gave the Roman Catholic Church a lot of wealth and power. Some of the Roman Catholic Church abused the power they held. So they misused it according, whenever they feel to, exploit others, they can, and nobody is there to punish them. The Pope, I hope you know who is the Pope. He's a head of the Roman Catholic Church. Competed with the king for the power and excommunicated kings. Excommunicated means excluded them from church or religious community. So they was boycotting the king and sometimes the entire country of that very king. Okay, so if you don't listen to what Pope is saying, then you are excommunicated, even your country can be. So why excommunication is so important? Let me tell you. Excommunication prevented people from receiving sacraments. Sacraments is a sacred Christian ritual from the Roman Catholic Church. So since they didn't receive sacraments, they could not go to heaven when they die. So obviously, if sacraments are not there, you're going to hell, that is for sure. So they were trying to encash this position. So the Pope and other Roman Catholic officials maintained a very lavish lifestyle. They were supposed to live a very simple lifestyle, but they were living a lifestyle which was not expected from saints. So Roman Catholic Church sold indulgence, pardon. Indulgence is a pardon for sin committed by during a person's lifetime. Means if someone has done something wrong, they're not going to be a part of heaven. They will go to hell. But if you buy this indulgence, then you are being forgiven. Okay. So basically this meant that people who bought indulgence paid for the forgiveness, thus making it possible for them to go to heaven. So have you ever heard that God will forgive you if you pay them? No. So all this wrong practices were going on in the church, and Martin Luther, you can see problems, corrupt practices, what I have. Martin Luther, this is the fellow or the personality which we are talking about. Martin Luther was a German monk who started questioning why we are selling indulgence. God had never said so. Okay, so indulgence was a power, pardon, and it was sold by the church. So Luther asked 95 statements or questioned the church practices and wanted the answer for all this. So this was the reason. So Reformation is basically a movement that led to Protestantism. The movement began in 1517 when Martin Luther, a German monk, protested against certain practices of the Roman Catholic Church. So the Reformation word is coming from reform. They wanted to reform the Catholic Church. People like Martin Luther, it was not only Martin Luther, many of them were there, wanted to get rid of the corruption and restore the people's faith in the church. So this made split in Christianity. There was one section was Roman Catholic and the other were Protestant. Okay.